We are going to highlight one of the key episodes of the rebel, that is the siege of Cawnpore. Cawnpore was an important garrison town for the East India Company forces. Nana Sahib was a prominent leader during the Great Uprising of 1857. During the initial stages of Indian freedom struggle, Nana Sahib declared his loyalty to the British. However, once he entered the magazine, Nana Sahib announced that he was a participant in the rebellion and took position of company treasury. He intended to be a vassal of Bahadur Shah II. On June 6, Nana Sahib's forces attacked the British entrenchment. The then British entrenchment is now a park. At that time, Nana Sahib's forces had been led to falsely believe that the entrenchment had gunpowder filled trenches that would explode if they got closer. The British held out India makeshift for 3 weeks with little water and food supplies and lost many lives due to sunstroke and lack of water.
नाना राव पार्क में कुओं में लोग पुराने अंग्रेजों के टाइम में लोग डाल डाल के काटे गए इसमें.
This is the same well where the British just dumped their dead soldiers during the Nana Rao attack on the British entrenchment. And this well has been covered after the independence for the safety.
The snip of fire and the bombardment continued until June 23, 1857. The British camp had been steadily losing its soldiers to assaults by Nana Sahib's forces. Nana Rao Ghat, earlier known as Sati Chaura Ghat, was the next important strategic location where Sati Chaura massacre took place.
On the right bank of River Ganga in the cantonment area lies this place of great historical importance since the Indian Mutiny of 1857.
Nana Sahib and his advisors came up with a plan to end the deadlock. Nana Sahib sent a female European prisoner, Rose Greenway, to the entrenchment to convey their message. In return for a surrender, he promised the safe passage of the British to the Sati Chaura Ghat, a dock on the Ganges from which they could depart for Allahabad. Finally, General Leviller decided to surrender in return for a safe passage to Allahabad.
सत्ताईस जून 1857 को बहुत से अंग्रेज मारे गए. उनकी स्मृति में पुनः जब अंग्रेजों का शासन हुआ तो उन्होंने इस मंदिर के सामने मतलब एक 14 वर्ग फुट में एक क्रॉस लगाया था. उसमें उन्होंने लिखा था 27 जून 1857. अंग्रेज चारों तरफ से पीड़ित हो गए कि अब हमारी जान नहीं बचेगी. तब नाना राव साहब से उन्होंने पेशकश की कि हमारी जान सुरक्षित रखी जाए, हम कानपुर से इलाहाबाद चले जाए. तो ठीक है भाई, तो 26 को उन्होंने 27 को यहाँ पर आए. तो जब यहाँ पर आए सब लोग, स्त्री लड़के बच्चे अंग्रेज जितने भी थे सब परिवार, तो यहाँ पर जब नाव में बैठने लगे तो किसी ने बिगुल बजा दिया, तो बिगुल बजाने का मतलब शुरू मारकाट शुरू। तो उसमें जो कुछ बचे, जो कुछ थोड़े बहुत बचे, तो ये बीबी घर, आपको बीबी घर नहीं मालूम होगा, ये ऑल सोल्स मेमोरियल चर्च, इसको बीबी घर कहते हैं पहले इतिहास में, वहाँ रखा गया। इसके बाद तात्या टोपे ने वो जो बचे हुए थे उन लोगों को कंपनी का नहीं बना, तात्या टोपे के सामने
बना,
उसमें उनको सबको दफना दिया। ये कहानी यहाँ की खत्म। और 31 मई 1860 को ये जो पीपल का पेड़ दिखाई दे रहा है वो जरा जरा, हाँ वो पीपल का पेड़ 31 मई 1860 को ब्रिगेडियर ज्वाला प्रसाद, क्रांतिकारी फौज के ब्रिगेडियर ज्वाला प्रसाद को फांसी दी गई। ये दो इतिहास की मतलब तारीखें हैं।
Although the East India Company later accused Nana Sahib of betrayal and murder of innocent people, no evidence has ever been found to prove that Nana Sahib had pre-planned or ordered the massacre. Some historians believe that the Sati Chaura Ghat massacre was the result of confusion and not of any plan implemented by Nana Sahib and his associates. Amid the prevailing confusion at Sati Chaura Ghat, Nana Sahib's general Tatya Tope ordered the 2nd Bengal Cavalry Unit and some artillery units to open fire on the British to kill the remaining British soldiers. The surviving British women and children, around 120 in number, were moved from the Sawada house to Bibi Ghar, a villa-type house in Cawnpore. They were later joined by some other women and children, the survivors from General Wheeler's force. Another group of British women and children from Fatehgarh and some other captive European women were also confined to Bibi Ghar. In total, there were around 200 women and children in Bibi Ghar. Nana Sahib decided to use these prisoners for bargaining with the East India Company. The company forces, consisting of around 1,000 British, 156 soldiers and 30 irregular cavalry, had set out from Allahabad under the command of General Henry Havelock to retake Cawnpore and Lucknow. On July 15, the British forces under General Havelock defeated the Bala Rao's army in the Battle of Aung. Soon it became clear that the company forces were approaching Cawnpore, and Nana Sahib's bargaining attempts had failed. Nana Sahib was informed that the British troops, led by the Havelock and Neil, were indulging in violence against the Indian villagers. This triggered an order on July 15 to kill the women and children imprisoned at Bibi Ghar. Sarovar Khan hired some butchers who murdered the surviving women and children with cleavers. Nana Sahib disappeared after the British recapture of Cawnpore. His general Tatya Tope tried to recapture Cawnpore in November 1857 after gathering a large army mainly consisting of the rebel soldiers from the Gwalior contingent. He managed to take control of all the routes west and northwest of Cawnpore, but was later defeated in the Second Battle of Cawnpore. Nana Sahib's ultimate fate was never known. After the independence of India, Nana Sahib was hailed as a freedom fighter, and the Nana Rao Park in Cawnpore was constructed in honor of Nana Sahib and his brother Bala Rao.